Last night, I sat down with Xseidet to look over a guy called Forrest Galante's new video about extinct Tasmanian tigers. Okay, Xseidet.
Yes.
I have something for you. I came to you and I was like, look, Xseidet, there is an extinct species of animal.
Yeah.
I've seen it. Would you believe me?
What animal? I'm curious now.
Are we talking like woolly mammoths?
Yeah, I was about to say, if you found a woolly mammoth, I'd be like, ah, bro.
I'd be like, nah. Nah, I don't believe it. Have you heard of a guy called Forrest Galante? He's the guy who got struck by lightning in that clip. Have you seen it?
No, no.
Oh, it's brilliant. Editor, put it in.
Hey, you haven't watched his latest video.
I haven't. I didn't realize he made
a new
one.
Are you even a fan?
He's only recently came up on my radar because he, as you can see, went to see the salamanders, and Richard was in that video. I was like, oh, okay, cool. And he even went on the Joe Rogan podcast to talk about extinct animals.
And these sightings, are they coming from credible sources?
I've done two expeditions looking for thylacine, and one of them, I was literally talking to the man who is the head park ranger for like the entire North Queensland. So he's a scientist by trade, a biologist by degree, and he says, I saw four of them.
He's banged on about this Tasmanian tiger for a long time. He's made a video with what he thinks is proof. We should watch that video.
Like the whole thing?
It is like almost an hour. And with all that context, this guy being the go-to source on the subject, opening up with this line.
I have photographic proof that the thylacine is still alive.
It's hard not to be excited. However, 2 seconds later, he says this.
At least that's the email that I got from this guy named Henry just last week. Henry tells me that his buddy Zach and Zach's dad were on a road trip through Tasmania when they pulled over to help an injured dog that ends up being a thylacine.
And one of the weirdest things about this guy's, among his story actually not checking out at all, is that he looks like this. Ah yes, someone who's definitely gonna be telling the truth. I mean, that's always a great way. It's like, I had a guy get in touch with me who had a friend of a friend who went on a... It should be like a case of, you know, we went in the outback or we were in a really place no one would ever go. Nah, it was by the side of a road, mate.
And maybe you guys at home can pick up on things that my team and I haven't. The whole thing is very curious.
I just love that image. I love the image. It's like,
respect the hustle, but like...
Yeah, exactly. If he made a video going... this is fake, this is not real. The video would get no views, right?
Yeah.
But if he makes a video going, could this be? Oh my God! Like, then yeah, everyone's gonna click on it because like, oh, this guy always is banging on about the Tasmanian tiger. Maybe he's finally found it.
Well, he wants it to be real so bad.
The videos he makes about extinct species do the most views. Like, they get the most traction.
This photo's f***ing crazy, dude. Wow. Holy f***. Oh my God.
I feel so bad.
He is so happy, but we've seen the images. And me and you, we see those pictures and instantly like, yeah, they're not real.
Yeah, nah, mate. It ain't real.
And also, we talk with him and he's covering his face up. He doesn't want to be identified. Why? Is the FBI trying to track you down for finding an extinct species? Like, what? Either he knows he's trying to prank this guy, and he just doesn't want to be shown on camera, or...
No, he just wants to see the outcome.
Oh yeah, he just wants to see the outcome. He's like, oh my God, I can't believe he bought it. If he gives them the actual picture, he could just look through the metadata and it'll tell him everything. It'll tell him location, it'll tell him what device it was taken with.
Pull over him, because we like dogs, obviously.
Yeah. That's how he gets around to this. Oh.
So I stopped the car because I want to pet that dog.
I want to pet that dog.
Can I pet that dog?
We run over because we don't want him to get away.
Get him before he can run. If you ran over to it, like any creature would probably run away from you, especially if it's had no contact with humans. With flashlights.
Yeah, with flashlights, and it's like it panics, but like one leg's broken, so it just starts running in circles in front of the camera so they can like take pictures. And that's why its mouth is open constantly.
Yeah, he's in
it's
shock.
Like, it's in so much pain that it's just screaming like fucking Tom and Jerry. You know?
It might have just been eating something. I don't know. Because there was blood. So either it got clipped by something or...
And it was like lying on the tarmac or it was in the bushes?
It was half on the tarmac. That is, I'm standing just in the road at this moment.
Yeah.
And I take the picture of him because I'm like, oh no, I want to like get the pictures essentially.
Yeah.
Oh no, I want to get the picture.
Oh no, I want to get the picture. Please be dead.
Please, yes. I don't want to help you. I want to get a picture of you before I help you.
And so I snap a few pictures because I'm like, I don't know what this is. I'm going to send them to Henry because he knows mammals and stuff.
Yeah.
I'm the turtle guy.
That's why he's hiding in the shell, huh?
Ah, yeah, that's why he's hiding.
And that's also why it takes him so long to get to the point.
Yeah, he's so slow.
Pull up these photos. We'll just do them one at a time here.
Oh, so he does have the images then. Like it says image 6630. He has the image sent straight through, so that will have all of its saved data on it. So all he needs to do is just like check the metadata.
That's him walking along the
fence. So sadly, this is the most like Bigfooty of all the photos, but it's the first one that came up in order, which makes sense because I think it was your last photo.
Did you notice something there?
What?
It's called image 6630.
Yeah.
Yeah. So all of them should be 662 or 661 or even 65.
The number shouldn't
go up, right? But if you look at that, 6642.
Oh, yeah.
All of a sudden, maybe he got it mixed up. Maybe that was the first image you took. He's taken 12 pictures before this one?
Yeah.
And it's in the wrong order? Ah! Rubbish. 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 Absolute rubbish.
What happened here? Like, what am I seeing here, Zach?
Flashlight is coming up at him from the side from my dad.
Okay.
No, it's right in front of him.
It's right in front of him. What's he talking about? you picked up on that straight away. I don't know exactly how much this looks like a Tasmanian tiger.
Oh, yeah.
That is the last footage ever taken of the Tasmanian tiger. Oh, no, that's a dinosaur.
That's the last footage. Yeah, you're right. This one actually looks more like a coyote.
Yeah.
The mouth there, it's almost like it's unhinged a little bit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like,
you're right. It does have a bit of that snake, like the jaws came off the bottom. Like the nose is just like cut off for some reason.
So if I look at the metadata on this photo, it says April 22nd, which is the day after you guys contacted me or Henry did. So I'm wondering, do you have an explanation for that?
So I think I sent it to him.
Yeah.
And he copied it.
Gotcha. Something got lost in the data transfer. All right, so...
Yeah, it'd be creation date that. Maybe modification date might have changed. So I tested this with an image I already had, made a copy of it, and would you believe the created date didn't change, but the modified date did change. So I think it's pretty safe to say that what he's saying is rubbish, and this was pretty much created the same day.
So sadly, this is the most like Bigfooty of all the photos, but it's the first one that came up in order, which makes sense because I think it was your last photo. So I'm going to pull up the next one now.
Oh, look, this one could be a copy. This one's got in brackets one, and this is even later. This is 6661. This is so much after the other one. How close did he get to the bloody thing? And this is 6689.
He's like running after it into the phone.
Yeah, the next picture's him like wrestling it to the ground, like, ah!
If you could get this close, you can literally grab it, you know what I mean? Like, you could throw your shirt over it or something.
Or you could take a picture in focus!
I appreciate that you guys sent every photo.
But they didn't. There are clearly photos in this sequence that are missing. In total, there are 62 photos missing. That's a lot of images in between taking pictures of the Tasmanian tiger, if it all happened that same night. If we believe that this even happened.
Where's the stripes?
Yeah, there's no stripes there at all.
What I find funny is that the film grain on this image especially is bigger in the bottom left than it is in the top right. It's like it put in.
It is like you just took an image, you went in Photoshop, you went distort, and you went like ripple. Or you changed it somehow just a little bit. Now, I know Forrest doesn't know much about Photoshop.
Yeah. Right? I mean, I don't know anything about art, but like that's like reflection.
Yeah.
That's a hard thing. Like, I don't care what yellow marker you have or anything. Like, that's pretty hard to get that, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
But that's clearly not true. This kind of film grain isn't organic. It's an effect. No modern phone is going to take pictures with this kind of film grain on it. So to prove my point, I took a similar render of a dinosaur that could obviously clearly fool Forrest into thinking that it was real. And this render is far too clean to be believable. So putting that crystallized effect over the top of it, we can compare this to the hoax images. And if we compare the dinosaur to this Tasmanian tiger, you can tell that the effect, it distorts the outline of the animal exactly the same way.
What is he up against there, right? The shadow's being cast against something, right?
I think that might just be, like, my dad.
Oh, yeah! That might be my dad, yeah, the shadow.
I think he means that his dad is casting his shadow over and behind the creature.
No. If he says that, that's rubbish.
Oh, I meant like, behind, like, see the outline? Yeah.
It's either my shoulder or my dad's shoulder or something.
No, that's 100% a replica silhouette of the ears. Yeah. The weird thing is the dimensions of all these photos. No camera takes pictures in square format, right? Like, unless you're taking pictures on Instagram or something.
Oh, yeah. Then they would have been cut or clipped.
And all these images take up exactly the same space on Forrest's desktop. So even though we don't know the exact dimensions, we can hazard a guess that they're pretty much the same size. Something like this has to be exported from Photoshop.
Wow. I don't even know what to say.
I know what to say. It's bullshit. That's what I'm gonna say.
Pitch me here tell me what to do here.
Please give me enough evidence that I can make the video. Please.
Yeah, just give me something, man, because you're bullshit.
I don't know what to think. I'm still very skeptical.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't think he is skeptical. Making content like this, you have to lean into it being real, right? Like, you want people... It's like ghost stories and ghost things that happen. You have to be like... I think he's just trying to play both sides. Like, I am skeptical, but it looks real. Plausible proof that these are not AI generated. Yeah, I didn't think they were. There we go! It's a thylacine. And that's when Xseidet told me something quite interesting.
Because, like, I literally saw these pictures.
Wait, you've seen these pictures?
Oh, no. My art is going around. I like to do art of extinct animals.
Wait. And this ended up leading us down a rabbit hole, which actually rumbled the entire thing. The guy Xseidet was talking about goes by the handle Archisuchus. And he makes these photorealistic dinosaurs and prehistoric creatures. He makes mannequins and stuff like that, like puppets, real life things. He'd already tweeted about this Forrest Galante video about the thylacine and mentioned that the images in there didn't look as realistic as his. And that's when he made this post, showcasing his actual thylacine model and that these photos looked way more realistic than the ones that he had been sent. And very rightly so, they do, because it is actually a real thing. However, something very interesting came of scrolling through his Twitter feed. And that was this image of him making the head of the thylacine, the Tasmanian tiger, with its mouth agape, looking very similar to another image we had seen before. So I quickly jumped into Photoshop, moved things around, matched things up, and would you believe, the teeth, the eyes, the ears, albeit were different because they'd probably Photoshopped another animal's ears into there. I don't know about you, flicking between the two images kind of shows that, yeah, whoever had made these hoax images had used this as a base and then digitally painted over the top of it before applying a crystallized effect over it as well. We've proved that at least one of these images is 100% fake. That is the one with its mouth agape and actually turned out to be the one image that this Zach guy, whatever he's called, didn't submit to Forrest, and Forrest had actually already found it. And with that, I think we can safely say, if one of them's fake, they're all fake. They're all similar, they're all probably Photoshopped from different things, they all have the same crystallizing filter, as I've proven before. So yeah, there you have it. It takes no energy or effort to throw images like this into the internet, and to have people pick them up and make videos on them, and for them to go viral, and before we know it, people think that this extinct species is coming back.
I want to believe. I really, really want to believe.
And it takes so much effort to disprove it. And I think it's important to realize that when you have a channel that's this big, spreading misinformation, especially when you are already skeptical of it and sounding very positive of it being real, is kind of harmful in a way. Giving this obvious hoax a platform is not a good look, I'll admit. And with everything being said and done, who stands to benefit from this video even existing at all? Is it Turtle Man? Or is it Forrest Galante, who has already made a video on it, has 500,000, if not even more, views now, has made hundreds, if not thousands, of dollars from the video? A little bit of food for thought. And I am by no way saying that he made this guy, he made the whole thing, he had a team create these images. I'm not saying that, just a theory. Out of everybody, he's the one that stands to benefit from this.
I don't want
to
share my face on the internet or anything like that.
Yeah. I feel you on that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He's the one who's gonna get subscribers and views from putting this out there. No matter how on the fence he pretends to be, because let's be honest, he's not. Where's the videos that are top 5 reasons I think the thylacine is extinct?
I don't know what to think. I'm still very skeptical. I don't know what to think. I'm still skeptical.
Methinks you protest too much. And afterwards, they talk about how he didn't sound like he was lying. Like he wasn't tripping over his words or anything.
The way that he can just say these things and make this full story.
Even like do the sound and everything, right? Yeah, like I'm with you. Like, I think if I was telling a lie, I'd have a hard time just like being like, yeah, this. You know, I'd be like, oh, I don't know. You know, like right. I'd be like, ugh. Like I'd be like, feel like I'm caught in a lie.
So let's bring it up. Montage of times that he's very clearly thinking on his toes.
So we get out. I've got my flashlight.
Yep.
My phone.
I wouldn't call my phone a flashlight. I might say, oh, I used the flashlight on my phone, but it's definitely not a mistake that I think anyone would make.
We walked across the road because we weren't worried about cars because we were like the only people we had seen in like an hour of driving. We run over because we don't want him to get away.
So they got out the car, walked towards it because they're like, ah, there's no cars, there's no need to rush. And then all of a sudden decided to run towards it in case it got away. But then why would you not start running towards it then if that was the case? Wouldn't you do that as soon as you stopped the car then? Like, oh, well, let's get to it. No, you walked and then you just were like, oh, and then I run.
We get over there and he stands up, you know.
It says April 22nd, which is the day after you guys contacted me or Henry did. So I'm wondering, did you guys, like, do you have an explanation for that?
So I think I sent it to him.
Yeah.
And he copied it.
Gotcha.
He doesn't have a good phone.
Yeah. So do you have better quality than this, or is this is it, right?
This is the same quality.
Yeah, gotcha.
So your friend copied it, but he had a terrible phone. So you're kind of like trying to excuse the quality. But then when Forrest asks you if you've got the better quality version, the original, you say it's the same quality. So did your friend take a picture of it with his terrible phone, which makes no sense, or... just everything is just terrible with this guy. We could be here for another 20 minutes making a montage of all the slip-ups and stumbles that he makes, but honestly, I don't have time for that, and you definitely don't have time for that. So anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this deep dive into thylacine fakery, I don't know what else you want to call it, leave a like, and until next time, I'll see you guys later. Oh, bye-bye.
And it made the shriek sound.
Uh-huh.
Almost like a meow.
That's pretty good.